We have some very sad breaking news just in. Australian television icon Bert Newton has died, age 83. The media legend had been battling complications since surgery to have his leg amputated in May. We'll bring you more details of his passing as they come to hand. First, we take a look back at his extraordinary life and career.
He's got the style.
In the history of Australian television, one name has almost always been there.
Here is Mr. Bert Newton.
Bert Newton.
Albert Watson Newton was born to a Catholic household in North Fitzroy in 1938. He first appeared on radio at the age of 14. At 20, he joined GTV9. And one appearance on the evening program in Melbourne Tonight led to one of television's greatest partnerships, Bert and Graham.
Do you remember that joke, look out for the Indians? What Indians?
The great thing about those early years was that everybody was learning together, including the audience.
Oh, ain't you that Bert Newton?
Yes, I am, as a matter of fact.
Over the next decade, Bert honed his skills in reacting to anything and everything that live television could deliver.
Well, can I help you?
No, just go ahead and do that.
Where do you have to stick it?
Graham Kennedy not only gave Bert his most enduring on-air partnership, but named the awards that Bert made his own, the Logies. In his record 19 times as host, his mastery of off-the-cuff quips, knowing looks and careful pauses made him look like a cheeky schoolboy sharing the joke with all of us.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
Oh.
May I?
Excuse us.
Congratulations.
It was especially handy during some edge-of-the-seat moments, such as when under-the-weather US actor Michael Cole let slip a word which had never before been heard on Australian television.
Oh, shit.
Congratulations, Mike.
It was my fault. That was one for a particular episode in the series, and Mike just mentioned the particular episode.
The incident generated hundreds of calls of complaint, but then...
Back in those days, they used to replay the Logies on Sunday afternoon, and so they edited that little bit out, and they got 3,000 calls from people complaining that it wasn't in.
This was an era when the entertainment world's biggest names would attend the awards night. But Bert had to talk fast after inadvertently insulting boxing legend Muhammad Ali, using a phrase from one of Bert's recent commercials.
Really?
I like one!
I like the boy.
Did you say Roy or boy?
I like the boy. There's nothing wrong with saying that.
Roy.
Yeah. Hey, hang on. No. I'll change religion. I'll do anything for you. I don't care.
All was clearly forgiven a few moments later.
1978 Gold Logie winner, Bert Newton.
Bert would go on to collect 4 of the gold statuettes.
Who else but up for somebody?
His second great on-air partnership came in 1975 with the man dubbed the Lanky Yank, Don Lane. Both men said the first time they met was on air and the chemistry was obvious.
Jaws working? Is it working for you?
I don't know, but I think I love you.
What we're going to do here is work your groin on the inside
of the leg.
What
do you think you're going to do here?
While the show was a vehicle for big-name guests, for many viewers, the big attraction was Bert and the wheel.
My name is Dammit Roulette. You want some? You like some?
I was in my bed, just lying in my bed, and I saw that thing. And I came out of my bed immediately, but now
I love you, I love you!
Wait a minute. It's Moonface!
Don Lane provided one of the Logies and Bert's most memorable moments when he collected the gold.
And I know you'll know that I mean this when I do it. Here, pal. 6 months in your house and 6 months in mine. How's that, all right?
The show lasted until 1983. 2 years later, Bert was dropped by the Nine Network. Unemployment and bankruptcy followed. But in 1991, he was back in yet another guise, morning TV host, back in his natural habitat, live television.
Probably thinking to yourself, well, He's now doing morning television. Surely death is next.
Far from being yesterday's man, Bert continued to provide inspiration for the next generation of performers.
He's about intellect. He's about a wisdom born of experience. And my life is much richer having him as a mate.
While professional partnerships would make his name in the industry, one personal partnership would outlast them all. Paddy McGrath was a singer and entertainer when the pair started dating in the early 1960s. By the time they married in 1974, policemen had to control crowds outside St Dominic's Church in Camberwell. She took his name, but equally he took hers. They would always be known as Bert and Paddy.
I suppose every day I think how lucky I am that I've got him. And I hope I never lose him.
It is a pleasure to be here tonight to introduce... Molly is actually kissing my wife, Patty, over there. A first for both of them. Well, there you go.
Their two children, Matthew and Lauren, were raised in the public eye.
He's fantastic. As well as being the top of his profession and an absolute inspiration, he's a great mate.
I've always been really proud of Dad, and I just hope he has a wonderful night.
Not as much as I'm proud of you.
Thanks.
Family bonds were tested by Matthew's court appearances and battles with drug abuse.
Yes, of course.
Bert was also tested by numerous health scares, one resulting in a quadruple bypass followed by several bouts of pneumonia. At least they could joke about it when Patty received an honour for, amongst other things, fundraising for medical research.
I've needed to know a little bit about medical research with Bert.
But another shock setback loomed. It started with just a toe infection in Christmas 2020. Months later, it had worsened. Doctors telling the diabetic he had a decision to make, his leg or his life.
It was needed, and he had a choice, and his choice was to live, really.
It bought the 82-year-old life's most valuable commodity, time.
We've all been sort of gathered around him a lot, and it's mainly for the grandchildren because he wants to watch them grow.
It would be wrong to label Bert as a TV survivor for his long career. He thrived on TV, in radio, and his latter years in theatre. Bert was a one-man history of Australian entertainment. Great television, he once said, is made up of moments. No one has given us more unforgettable moments.
Without you,
without you,
without you,
without you,
without you.